What's up everyone? Today we are color matching two really different shots. All right, so here I am in Premiere Pro and this is a project we're filming recently for charity, and we filmed with a Sony A6300 on a gimbal and the Canon C100. So obviously they have two different color profiles and we have to match both. I already found two shots really similar to help me establish my baseline. Here is the Canon shot and here is the Sony one. Both were shot in log, but S-log is a lot more flat than C-log. Okay, first we will put the Lumetri effect on both clips so we can just search for it and slide it on your two shots. Sometimes what I do, and this can be good for you if you get distracted with colors, is to turn the image to a black and white image to begin with. You can do this by going into the Lumetri panel, basic correction, and turn the saturation down. By doing that, you can focus on the contrast and exposure of the two shots without being distracted by the colors. Again, it's not mandatory, but it helps. Once this is done, just pull up your tools. Lumetri scopes and the reference monitor are always what I use. And we can go between the two shots while looking at our RGB parade and see the difference between the two. Here you can see the C-log shot is between 10 and 80 and that the S-log shot is between maybe 18 and 65. That means that we have a contrast difference between the two shots. Since Sony has more latitude, I'm trying to make that one match the C-log shot. So we will increase the contrast here. We can do a quick comparison looking at both RGB parade that confirms what we see on the reference monitor. We are a little too dark on the S-log shot, so we may have to shift that, try a couple settings, see what that works well. And guys, trust your eyes too. The tools are here to help you, but your eyes should be what you trust the most. If it looks right, but the RGB parade is a little bit off, that's fine. Also, if you don't nail it on the first try, that is fine. There is a lot of push and pull, a little bit here, a little bit there, and back to it. Here, looks like I found the right setting. It looks good. Now, we can put the color back into it, go back to saturation and hit reset or type 100. Next, we will bring that shot into the same color space overall. So what I do is look where the difference is. Again, comparing the two shots, looking at the RGB parade, we can see that the Canon C-log shot has more red. Again, guys, looking at the reference monitor or just the shot overall will tell you the difference. You don't necessarily need the RGB parade to see that there is a difference. Trust your eye. If you're not sure what is wrong, experiment and you will get better at it. Anyhow, in this shot, we clearly see that the Sony isn't as red as the Canon one. So what I do is add temperature first, see where it brings the image overall. If you're not sure which way to go, right and pluses are warm tones and left or minuses are cold. Red is warm, blue is cold. So let's start adding some and see where it brings you. Again, validating with the reference monitor and RGB parade, we can see that we're still missing a bit. I am using the red cup and the floor as a reference in this instance, so we need some more. Sometimes what I do is to go to an extreme and pull it back. Again, push and pull, it's a constant process here, and bouncing between the two shots, we are getting closer. Now, we see another problem. The red cups are way off. We can see the Sony S-log red cups are more toward the red-purple side, while the Canon C-log cups have more shades of yellow and green. And again, if you can see that right away, don't worry, it comes with time. So next we'll go down to HSL secondary. This is meant to target a specific color. So select the color picker and select the color you want to target. Here we said the red was way off, so that's what we will select. And the program will give you a good base to start with. What I usually do is enable show mask. That way you're seeing exactly what I'm selecting. And see, in this case, we can see that we are missing so much tones that we need to play with the sliders. So the sliders all have a specific purpose. The top one, H, is for hue, S is for saturation, and L is for lightness. You can just start playing around until you get a good selection of your color. And again, guys, this will require a lot of finagling and push and pull until you're happy with your selection. Then I often put a little blur in there and a little denoise. It helps blending the color. Don't overdo it though, otherwise it will create some weird color halo. Once you have your selection, then you can start playing with that color and that color alone. Isolated like this, we can clearly see how different they are. And what I was telling you earlier, one red is mostly purple and the other leans toward green. If you look at the color wheel, the two colors on each side of red are purple and green. So first we will move the needle toward green and see what that does. Remember, push and pull. At first I introduced too much green, but that's okay. Just pulling back toward orange, and there you go. We found a happy medium. The color is getting closer and closer. Guys, let's see where we started and where we are now. This is before and now. I'm very happy with those colors, but something is missing. Saturation. The Canon C-log is more saturated than Sony S-log, so we need to reintroduce saturation. There you go, much better. You remember what I told you the whole time? Push and pull, reintroduce saturation, change the overall tone, so I will go and pull back the temperature. There you go. I am a little bit more happy with this. We could spend a little bit more time, but for today, that's gonna be good enough. And this is what the end product will be. All right, I hope you enjoyed the video and you learned from it. If you have any comments, leave them in the comment box below. As always, find us on Facebook, subscribe to the channel, and see you next time.